A New York court rules to distribute $13.75 million to martial law victims under the late President Ferdinand Marcos. American lawyer Robert Swift, representative of the Philippine Human Rights Victims, says in a press statement that New York Judge Catherine Faia found that there's, quote, an actual and apparent authority to bind the Republic of the Philippines to the settlement. This affects the prized paintings of the former dictator's wife, Imelda Marcos, and her former New York aide, Vilma Bautista. The paintings were seized by the U.S. government, so the money is in U.S. custody. Swift clarifies that under the agreement, the government gets $4 million and the 9,536 victims get $13.75 million. Filipino lawyer Rodrigo Domingo said the foreign court ruling would be enforceable here in the Philippines. He told Rappler in a text message that, quote, the DOJ, PCGG, and OSG were overruled by Judges Catherine Faia and Manuel Rial. The Supreme Court en banc orders the government to answer a petition to stop a controversial loan agreement with China. Opposition lawmakers from the Makabayan Bloc filed the petition against the loan agreements on April 4, urging the court to issue a temporary restraining order for the 3.69 billion peso Chico River Pump Irrigation Project. Makabayan's petition argues that several provisions of the loan agreement violate the Constitution, including a confidentiality clause, an after-the-fact approval by the Monetary Board, and the requirement that the contractor be a Chinese company. The Office of the Solicitor General has to submit the comment within 10 days. Vice President Lenny Robredo says not even the President is excused from truthfully declaring all of his wealth in a Statement of Assets, Liabilities, and Net Worth, or SAL-N. This is her comment after President Rodrigo Duterte tells the PCIJ his family's wealth is none of their business. In a chance interview in Iloilo City, Robredo says all government officials, not just the elected but even the appointed ones, are obliged to declare all their assets in their SAL-Ns. She adds, everyone is equal in the eyes of the law, whether in a high position or not. Dallas Mavericks star Dirk Nowitzki confirms his retirement from the NBA. The 40-year-old German ends his 21-season career after his team's win over the Phoenix Suns. An emotional Nowitzki tells the crowd at Dallas American Airlines Center, quote, as you guys might expect, this is my last home game. Nowitzki was selected to the All-Star Game 14 times. He also earned the NBA MVP award in 2007 and the Finals MVP in 2011. Three Camarines Sur High School students get planets named after them after they bagged an award at the 2018 Intel International Science and Engineering Fair. Eugene Rivera, Giselle Manzanero, and Keith Cadores won second place at the fair's physical energy category with their study, Design and Development of Solar Tracking Arduino-Rooted PV Panels. Their research looks into harnessing energy through photovoltaic cells, a type of solar cell, as a renewable energy source. The photovoltaic cells open when the sun is out, track the sun's movement, close when the light source is no longer detected, and respond to humidity and temperature to maximize power generation. Their design got them a prize of $1,500. The Intel ICEF is the world's largest international pre-college science competition with some 1,800 students from over 75 countries showcasing their research.